doing art and getting into it at a very young age. I would just doodle wherever I can, either on paper, on napkins, boxes, on my body. I would always find a way to draw, and throughout the years, just from there, never stopping, and it just improved my skills. I've been doing it for a young age, and it's my escape from reality, my responsibilities, and it's the one thing that I feel makes me feel free and be able to express myself and just let my mind be roam free and do whatever it wants. Some of the struggles that you can confront yourself when doing art, especially freelance art, is getting to be known. And the industry is basically a whole competition. Like, you have to stand out from a plethora of such amazing artists from different ages and have different views and like are inspired by so many things, and they have such high skills. It's just a matter of like standing out and showing, this is what I offer. I hope everyone enjoys and brings a message.
Have a mess.
This one was a tattoo commission. It's supposed to go on the ribs. She paid me for it, but she completely forgot I made this for her, and I told her, hey, when can we meet up so I can like turn in your artwork, and she just never did. And my waifus, man. Big titty waifus. Some of my inspirations has to be, for one, Frida Kahlo, being the first Latina Mexican artist in a topic of surrealism paintings and a male dominance is very inspiring with me, not only for her being a woman, but also showing her struggles as a woman from her trauma and imprinting that into art and having everyone see it and have a sense of an emotion, a message, and an empowerment. Also, like places, I love gardens, flowered fields, different countries like Japan. When you go to Tokyo, the buildings, the signs, it's a vibe, and you just take it all in, and then you interpret it the way others may not, like through art. Maybe you can create an illustration that a character can live in that environment and brings them even more into life. I started wanting to do like a cartoon style. I took most inspiration from this one artist. I can't remember her name right now, but I really like her character designs, like the way she drew them. And I wanted to do that for myself, but I don't know. I feel like it's too much her and not really me. And I wanted to do some like sexual oriented drawings. These were supposed to be for a show. I know my friend, he was doing a show and he was actually selling some of his sketches, and he offered me to like start doing some doodles in like ink, and we could just sell them at the event. It was like a punk dance like rave thing, mosh pit. Usually I come up with my ideas from like either dreams I have when I'm sleeping, or maybe if I'm out and about, if I go downtown, a lot of people tend to dress a certain way, and it's very eye-catching. It's either on trend with street fashion and all that stuff that very influences me, because I mostly draw female characters, and a lot of them are very airy. There's a lot of movement to them. They're very high-end fashion, and just something people are relatable to now. And I think it's basically upon the media right now with all the aesthetics and the fashion and trends. More drawings. I love doing portraits, especially females. I rarely draw any males, purely because I feel like I draw them very feminine, which is, that's not a bad thing, but I'm steering more into girls. And I'm very like not neat when it comes to my art. Like when I do art, this is literally, I took the jumbo Sharpies and I just went like this to cover her shirt. Can't draw hands for shit. and just the squiggly lines for curly hair, and I feel like it gives it a nice effect. If art is your passion or any other thing, don't give up. No matter the circumstance, no matter what anyone says, keep improving. Show everyone that you got this and you have a message and you have something to show the world. Maybe something invoke emotion or just purely joy, and to express something fun and lively and youthful. Never give up and always pursue what you want to do.